Hey Siri, what's the weather today?
It's 82 degrees Fahrenheit and sun success shining today.
What do Microsoft's Cortana, Google's Voice Assistant, Amazon's Alexa, and Apple's Siri all have in common?
I'm Siri, your virtual assistant.
They're all female voice assistants. And if the entire future of voice assistants is female, then now we have to ask ourselves, does that even really matter? I believe it does. This is your digital service announcement.
This is a digital service announcement.
I exist beyond your human concept of gender.
The first voice we can identify is our mother's voice when we're in the womb. The female voice is thought to be comforting, welcoming, and overall preferred. These are the main arguments for why so many voice assistants are female. Most AI voice assistant companies will confirm this. Overall, they say people just like the female voice better. And you know what? They're not wrong. From Siri to Alexa, these technology companies don't just choose the female voice automatically. They run user tests. I mean, if I'm trying to get mass adoption for something, I would choose whatever voice people like most too. Head of Amazon's smart home told press that a woman's voice was better received in all of their user tests. Tests outside of these companies have also confirmed these results. A study by a market research company, Norstat, also found that 90% of users are satisfied with Alexa's, Cortana's, Siri's, and Google Assistant's respective female voices. Okay, so if all of this is true, then why is Watson originally made and only available with a male voice? A Stanford University study confirms that it's not that everyone prefers a female voice. Preferences for male over female voices stem from the fact that voices automatically trigger a certain stereotypical expectation in our minds, because voice assistants are meant to do simple tasks for you, but Watson was built to be the source of truth and information. See the trend here? But it's not just IBM's choice to select a male voice that shows inherent stereotypes. Domino's launched Drew with a male voice, the pizza guy, and Google Assistant's first British accented voice was male. In the UK, high-class servants were generally male butlers. Both of these also play into stereotypes. So why not make a gender-neutral voice? The same study from Stanford University shows that we impose characteristics on a machine that don't exist simply because of the voice. As a company, if you can do one thing to make a machine more relatable and perceived as welcoming by users, not by changing code or changing any of the types of words that the machine uses, but just by using a female voice, that's what you do. So this brings us back to so what? So what if all the voice assistants are female? If we reversed all the voice assistants and made them male, we'd also have a problem with that. It's just a voice and it's proven by tests to be more accepted. But just because it might not be a big deal now doesn't mean it won't be a big deal in the future. Think about where we are heading to. We are on the cusp of major AI revolutions. More and more voice assistants will pop up everywhere. If Domino's Pizza already has one, then soon enough your laundromat will have one too. Imagine that everywhere are female voices assisting us in what we do. There can be a lot of negatives from this. One, maybe a crazy reverse thing might happen, where we believe only intelligent beings have female voices. Two, maybe the worst thing happens and we begin to associate female voices even more in the future with subservient things. Either way, a future with female-only voice assistants is not good if it might further enforce our gender biases. And we're heading there right now. Samsung's Bixby is female, DataBot for Windows and Xbox is female, Bank of America's Erica is female. And it's important, if we keep making virtual assistants female because personal assistants were commonly female and research bots male because researchers were commonly male, then making virtual bots perpetuate the same stereotype means we will never get out of stereotypes. In fact, bots can get us out of this vicious cycle if we make an effort. If some companies see the advantage to male voices as a differentiator in a sea of only female voice assistants, and if other companies make Watson-like bots to be female in voice, then maybe we can make a change. But we also have a role to play. Stop inherent biases you might have in hearing a male versus female voice. And you know what? Go ahead right now and change your Google Assistant or Siri to a male voice. Yep, you can do that for Google Assistant and Siri. Make that change. Make the world of voice assistants a little more diverse so that it goes from sounding like this.
I'm Siri.
To this.
I'm Siri.